I'm the FanFic Critic. I read it, you listen. Today's episode's going to be short, like the last one, and the one before that, and the one before that, and the one before that. I don't think this one will involve rape, though. Especially... I do apologize for how abruptly the last episode ended. I was just so mad that I was afraid that if I said anything, I probably would have destroyed my entire house. So yes, I needed to cool down. Lots and lots of drinking, let's put it that way. But I'm fine now. I am in a sound enough mind to do the next fanfic. And yes, I'm still wearing the same outfit that I was the last few hundred episodes. I guess it's kind of consistent with my original show. So, yeah. So, okay then. This fanfic is called Dora the Explorer by Princess Hime of Dreams-chan. Apparently, Hime also means princess. So this author's name is Princess of Dreams-chan. Redundant much? It's a Dora the Explorer and Indiana Jones crossover. The summary is Dora grows up with Indiana Jones. It's rated fiction T. It's in English. It's suspense romance with 486 words, two reviews, one faves. It's not complete, but then again, it was published back in 2010. Let's hope that the next fanfic I review is longer than frickin' 400 words. Let's hope it's at least 1,000 words, something I can actually go with. My God. Dora the Explorer. Okay. Dora, after many years of Mexican exploring, after so many years of constant use of abuse, her map and backpack had decided that they needed better work and had moved on to work with Blue and Blue's Clues. Okay then. Dora decided it was time for a change. A new setting and new partners, so she went to Craigslist. After many hours of extensive researching, she eventually stopped looking at the strictly platonic ads and went to the general labor section. Upon her arrival, she browsed until happening upon an ad stating, "I am Indiana Jones! My father is Sean Connery! I want to have many adventures! I have my own backpack and map!" What a catch! Holy! Dora screamed at her monitor and immediately sent an email to the contact info. Within a week, after several email exchanges, Dora and her soon-to-be partner met at a local Starbucks. Dora got a green tea and Indy purchased a grand latte. Halfway through the conversation, Indy had to suddenly leave the table due to a sudden bout of the mud butt. After 5 minutes of anal leaking, a lovely visual, Indy was able to stumble back to the cafe table. He muttered out apologies, which Dora dismissed because she was ready to get down to business. So after Indy had sat down and composed himself, Dora pulled out her laptop and got herself onto the internets with Craigslist. "Ihura!" she exclaimed upon finding an ad she found suitable for their needs. "Wanted space pilots! Hell yeah, that sounds like a cool time. Hopefully we can find a crystal skull while we're there." Indiana commented as enthusiastic in a manner as possible for someone who was recovering from the butt runs. So Dora emailed the contact with their resumes. The employer was so impressed by their adventure times that he hired them on the spot, and 3 hours and 34 minutes later, the duo found themselves strapped into a space jet to fight the Russians that were trying to take over the world. In the roughly three and a half hour time period they had alone together, Dora and Indy had gotten the googly eyes, Dora's a child, and boner and girl boners for each other. As a result of this, when they took off, she decided that she needed to get up on his hot adventure dick. I thought this was supposed to be rated. This is not in the right rating. Thankfully, as co-pilot, she didn't have any actual work to do, so she was free to do all the dick sucking she needed to do. Yes, this is in the wrong rating. People, report this story. Thank you. "Holy!" she exclaimed, launching herself for his adventure. Zipper, for within, was held his mighty adventurer penis. Once she found her goal, she went down, bobbling up and down his cock like a silly turkey. Thankfully, Indy was a skillful man and managed to still bomb the Russians at the same time come to completion. So the summary of this story was very misleading. The summary says, Dora grows up with Indiana Jones. It doesn't say Dora gives Indiana Jones a blowjob. So I am to assume that Dora the Explorer is still supposed to be a child in this. So you're trying to imply that Indiana Jones is a pedophile. You know, I know that he likes his ladies and stuff, but he would not be a pedophile. Why? Why do you people feel the need to ruin these characters and make them into dicks? You made Simon Belmont into a rapist. You've made Indiana Jones into a pedophile. You made whatever her name is from the last story's father into a pedophile and a rapist and an incestuous fuck. I'm not sure if the father's in the show or not, but if he is and if you guys like his character, guess what? He got ruined for you there. What's with you people? What the fuck is with you people? This might have been one thing if maybe you had to be the Dora was, like, older and stuff, but no. And this story itself was such a waste of time, and it was so stupid. This person was probably trolling. I hope they were trolling, but they probably weren't. This is, oh my god, I really hope the next fanfic is not only longer, like much, much, much longer, but is actually good. Well, I'm the fanfic critic. I read it, you listen, and I need to wash my eyes. Hello, it's an announcement video at the end of a Fanfic Critic episode. I don't think I've done this before. Well, maybe I did it once. And you're probably wondering why I look a lot different. Well, the episode was filmed back in July, and it's now January. Well, for me it is. When you guys are watching this video, you might be watching it like 10 years in the future. Okay then, this quick little announcement is kind of an apology for episodes not really being aired frequently. I do apologize. I've been really busy lately. I'm also working on something for the site I'm on, Manic Expression, so that might take up a little bit more of my time. But once when that's done, hopefully I should be able to pop these episodes out a lot quicker. I have all of the season pre-filmed. It's just a matter of me editing it. And these episodes so far haven't been too hard to edit, but after episode 210, or more appropriately episodes 210 and onward, will probably take longer to edit because the fanfics actually have more content in them. Yes, so the little short fanfics are going to be going away soon. The second half of the season will be much better than the first half. So yeah, hope you guys all had a wonderful new year. And yay for this episode being the first episode aired in 2014. We survived the apocalypse. Woohoo! Or the end of the world. The apocalypse world. No. The Mayans said we were supposed to go bye-bye back in 2012, actually, so I'm a little late on that. Oh, well, I don't really pay attention to that. You always get these theories about the end of the world showing up eventually, so we survived either way. So, hope you guys have a wonderful new year.